Yes, good morning students. Today we study chapter 2, four operations. What are operations? What are the four operations? First, addition. Second, subtraction. Third, multiplication. Then fourth, division. Four operations are, what are the four operations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Again, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. First, the first operation is addition. We will study today addition. We will study today addition. Addition. Then you 35,478 and 42,315. We add this two number. Then 8 plus 5, 13. Carrying 1, 1 plus 7, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 4 plus 3, 7, 5 plus 2, 7, then 3 plus 4, 7. The first number is we write addend. What is we say? Addend. The second number also addend. The result of two number is called sum. The result of two addends is called sum. Again, first number is addend, second number also addend. The result is also called the sum. The result is also called sum. Then, for example, we write Find the sum. 4,38,175 and 3,15,172. Again, read the number 4,38,175 and 3,15,172. First, you arrange these numbers in according to place value. You arrange these numbers in place value according to place value. Write ones, tens, hundred, thousand. 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh. One step you take. Then you arrange, you write in one's place. 5, 7, 1, 8, 3, 4. Here also 2, 7, 1, 5, 1, 3. Then add these two number. Then we add. We start with ones place. Don't you start with in lakhs. We start with ones place. Your right hand side start. 5 plus 2, 7. Then 7 plus 7, 14. You write this 14 carrying over. Then 1 plus 1, 2. You take a carrying over also. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. Then 8 plus 5, 13. Carry over 1. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 4 plus 3, 7. This is addend. This is also addend. This is result is sum. Now we study the properties of addition. What do you study? Properties of addition. We will study properties of addition. Properties of addition. Properties of addition. First property is ordering property. Ordering property. First property is ordering property. In a two numbers, in any two numbers, any number we added in, we all change the order. In any order, the result is not changed. In a ordering property, in a ordering property, we change the order of the number. We change the order of the number. The result is not changed. The result is not changed. That property is called ordering property. What is ordering property? In an ordering property, we change the order of the number. We change the order of the number. The result is not changed, or the sum is not changed. For example, 4,742 and 5,175. First, you arrange in column ways ones, tens, hundred, thousand. Right? 2, 4, 7, 4, 5, 7, 1, 5. Then add this number. 2 plus 5, 7. 4 plus 7, 11. Carrying one. Then 1 plus 7, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. 4 plus 5, 9. Then we change this order and we write 5,175 in first. 5,000. Again we write ones, tens, hundred, thousand. 5,175. 5, 7, 1, 5. Then 2, 4, 7, 4. Then add this number. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 4, 11. Carrying 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 7, 9. 5 plus 4, 9. Look here. First we write 4,742. Then 5,175. Here we write the sum is 9,977. Here first we write 5,175, then we write 4,742. The answer is 9,970. Then both answers are same. Both answers are same. We change the order. This is going this, we go this. The same. We change the order. The answer is same. That property is called ordering property. But the property is called ordering property. Second, grouping property. Second, grouping property. Grouping property. Second, grouping property. Two or more numbers we group any order. Two or more numbers we group any order. The final result is not changed. The final result is not changed. That property is called grouping property. Again, two or more numbers group any order, the final result is not changed. That is called grouping property. For example, 4172 plus 3175 plus 1345. First, I group these two numbers. 4172 plus 3175. Then plus 1345. You understand it? Then now we arrange this 4172 plus 3175. Add this 2 plus 5, 7. 7 plus 7, 14. Carrying 1, 3, then 7. Then 7347, then add this number 1345, then add this 7 plus 5, 12, carrying 1, 9, 6, 8. This property is called a grouping property. Then next here we take these two in group. 3175 plus 1345. First we add these two number. 10 carrying 1, 12 carrying 1, 5, 4. Then plus 4172. 2, 9, 6, 8. Here, look here. First I change, I make the group 4172 and 3175. Then the final answer is 8692. Then next group is 3175 and 1345. Then we add 4172. The final answer is 8692. The final answer is not changed. We change in any order in group. The final answer is not changed. That property is called grouping property. Understand the grouping property? First property, ordering property. Second property, grouping property. Third property is zero property. What? Zero property. Zero property. The sum of any number add zero, the result is the number itself. That is, the sum of any number and zero, the sum of any number and zero, the result is the number itself. For example, 45,950 plus 0 is equal to, what is the answer? 45,950. Again, 3 lakh plus 0 is equal to, 3 lakh plus 0 is equal to 3 lakh. Understand what are the properties of an addition? First property, ordering property. Second, grouping property. Third, zero properties. Now we add these word problems. In a country, in a village, you take in a village, in a city, in a city. There are 3,78,975 men, 4,50,175 women, and 2,50,700 children. Find the total population of the city. You remember, WH words are not come in statement. Which are WH words are not come in statement. What are how much? How many? Find. What? These words are not come in statement. These words are not come in statement. What are? How much? How many? Find. What? Again say, how much? How many? Find. What? These words are not come in statement. First you read the question. First understand the question. What do you ask you? In a city, there are 3,78,950 men, 4,25,175 women, and 2,50,700 children. Find the total population of the city. Understand the question? Then this question is identify. How to identify this is addition, this is subtraction, this is multiplication, this is division? First is then our four operation. First is addition. We understand addition. What are the words come in question? Then first a total. What come a total or in all? What word? In all or together. Which are the words come in question? Total, in all, together. Again say total, in all, together. First you check. Your question, any in all is come, any total is come, any together is come, then you underline that word. You underline that word. Here which word come? Total come. Therefore, this word problem is addition. First we write the solution. Statement write. In a city there are men. First we men is countable. Therefore, we write number of. What do you write? Number of men. Number of men is equal to 3,78,950. Second line, number of women. Very good. Number of women is equal to 4,25,175. 4,25,175. Then third line, number of children. Number of children. How many children? 2,50,700. Then you add this number. 0 + 5 + 0 = 5. 5 + 7 = 12. Carrying 1 = 10, 11 = 18. Carrying 1 = 9, 14. Carrying 1 = 10, 15. Carrying 1 = 7, 8, 10. Then we write total population. Total population. Then final answer, we use the word hence. Answer, final answer. Hence. What is the spelling of hence? H E N C E. We write hand, so, therefore. We write these words in final answer. What are the words? Hence, so, therefore. Here we use hence. Hence, 10,54,825 people, the population of the city. The population of the city. Now this end the question. Understand it? Any problem? No. Then you do the in exercise. Question 1 and 2 of exercise number 2.1. You do the exercise homework. Do question 2 and 4 of exercise 2.1 in book. In book 1 and 3 in this is in notebook. In notebook okay. Thank you for listening me. Any doubt you ask? No. Thank you for listening me.